Hello guys, welcome to Naveen Automation Labs. This is Naveen here. So guys, today I'm going to cover that the last topic of Cucumber, that is called hooks in Cucumber. What do you mean by hooks? Okay, it's very, very simple topic, but a little confusing. But I think once you practice, then easily you will get to know that, okay, how to use, what is the purpose, okay, why we use hooks and all. So just like in TestNG, I'll give you some basic idea. Just like in TestNG, we have @ before. Okay, @ before method, @ before test, @ before class, annotations are available. Same thing for post conditions. Once the test case is done, we have @ after, @ after class, @ after method, annotations are available. Just like we have hooks are available in Cucumber. So how to do that? So let's see, I have prepared some script for you guys. Let's see, I have this particular very simple feature file. Forget about this code, this is a commented line. Very simple scenario I have written that create deal test, given user is on deal page, then user fills the deals form and deal is created. But before that, I want to launch the browser. I want to enter the URL and then I want to log it into the system. And then this particular step I'll be executing. And then once this particular scenario is done, what I want to close the browser. And these three, four prerequisites and post conditions are common for all the scenarios, right? For each and every scenario, I have to launch the browser. I have to log in into the system. And once that particular scenario is done, then I have to close the browser. So how to achieve this thing? Okay, because no need to write launch the browser and enter the URL again and again. Okay, in that particular scenario, if you have 100 scenarios, so 100 times you are writing the same thing in that particular scenario. Okay, so how to do that? So to this thing, simple, let's see, this is a hooks.feature file I have created, and three features are available. I mean, three steps are available, given, when, then. And I have created this, see, given, when, then, I have created like this over here. User is on deal page, user fills the deals form, and deal is created. Very simple, right? So now if you want to define the prerequisites that in the form of @ before and @ after, you just need to write like this. Okay, you just need to write like this, guys. Let's see, @ before annotation, that's a setup method. @ before, that's a tear down method, just like we did in TestNG, remember? Similar kind of things we are giving over here. And make sure that this @ before and @ after, you are importing from here, Cucumber API. Don't import it from JUnit. Okay, please import it from Cucumber API in Java package. Now what will happen? This @ before annotation, this method will be executed before this particular scenario. Before this particular scenario, it will be executed, and then it will execute step by step. And then all the three steps are done, then @ after annotation will be executed. That is your tear down method, that is your close the browser will be executed. I'm not writing any Selenium code, guys. Selenium code you can practice later. Okay, so what will happen if you run this program? Let's run it in test runner. I'll be writing this hooks.feature. Okay, just a minute, let me check the recording is on. Okay, yeah, cool. Okay, so let's run it. So if you see the output, see the output, very simple, that just a minute. Yeah, okay, launch the firefox, enter URL for free CRM app, launch the Firefox, enter the URL for free CRM app, and then okay, then user is on deal page. Just a minute, I think step definition file, just a minute, give me a minute. Let me comment other than this thing. It's getting confusing. Okay. Just a minute, guys. Let me close all these classes. Okay. So this is a test runner. This is a step definition. Now run it. Now see the output. See. What is my scenario? First scenario is this. User is on deal page. But before this line, user is on deal page. Before this line, see, this is a prerequisite. Precondition is getting executed because of this @ before method. Launch Firefox, enter URL for free CRM app, right? And then user is on deal page. User is on deal page. Then create a deal. And then deal is created. And then deal is created. And then once everything is done, close the browser. Simple. So this is called tagging. Okay, this is called, sorry, hooks, not tagging. This is called hooks. @ before and @ after. So hooks are used in Cucumber to define the preconditions and the post conditions. Precondition means, let's see, launch WebDriver, launch Firefox, enter the URL, delete all the cookies, fetch the test data from the Excel files. All these things you can define in your @ before annotation. And once everything is done, all the test cases are done, then you can define inside @ after annotation. Like that. And it will work for all the scenarios. Let's see, tomorrow I have this particular scenario. Okay. Let's see, I have another scenario that create contact. This is another scenario. So for this particular scenario, again, I need @ before and @ after. So you can define like this. @ before and @ after will work for second scenario also. Right? So if you run this program now, so first it will be executed for deal and then it will be executed for contact. See, launch the Firefox, enter the URL for free CRM app, then user is on contact, create a contact, contact is created, and then close the browser. Same thing happened for deal. Launch Firefox, URL, create the deal, deal is created, close the browser. And this is for contact. So for before each and every scenario, it will be executed like this. Okay, for before this particular scenario, @ before will be executed. @ after will be executed after this particular scenario. So if you have tomorrow 100 scenarios, so before each and every test scenario, @ before and @ after will be executed respectively. @ before will be executed before the scenario and @ after will be executed after the scenario. And the same concept will be applied for scenario outline also with examples keyword. Let's see, this particular scenario will be executed 3 times with mail 1, mail 2 and mail 3. Right? So 3 times this particular scenario will be executed. So before each and every iteration, @ before method, and after each and every iteration, @ after method will be executed. So if you run this program with scenario outline also, it will be executed. Okay? So 4 scenarios got executed properly, right? So you can practice. This is called hooks in Cucumber. Very simple. Define hooks like this, @ before and @ after. No need to do anything in your feature file. Okay, this is done. Now what we have to do, another concept is called tagged hooks. Okay, tagged hooks also very popular. Sometimes we use, sometimes we may not use. It's up to you. Tagged hooks means, let's see, I have 3 scenarios. I'll give you one feature file example. Let's see, this is my feature file. How many scenarios are there? 3 scenarios. Scenario number 1, scenario number 2, and scenario number 3. What I want to define 2 types of hooks over here. First hook, global hook, which will be applicable for all the scenarios. Let's see, launch the browser. Right, browser will be launched before each and every scenario, and then @ after also close the browser. Browser will be closed each and every after each and every scenario. Now, what I want for second scenario, first scenario, for third scenario, I want to do some special condition also. But let's see, for second scenario, I want to do some precondition, but that precondition is only applicable for second scenario. I don't want to include that particular @ before and @ after for first scenario or third scenario, which is only and only applicable for second scenario. So how to do that? That is called tagging, tagged hooks. Okay. So how to do that? So to do this thing, let's see, this particular scenario is tagged with @ first annotation. This particular scenario is tagged with @ second annotation. And this particular scenario is tagged with @ third annotation. Right, and then I'll create one step definition file. That's my step definition file. See, okay, let me remove this ordering. I'll tell you what is order later. Okay. Let me remove like this. Now, there are two types of hooks are available. This is called global hook. Okay, these two are global hooks. Global hooks means this add the red before and add the red after is applicable for all these three scenarios, which will be executed before and after respectively after each and every before each and every scenario, which is written over here. How many scenarios are there? Three scenarios. So before these three scenarios, this add the red before setup method will be executed, and after each and every scenario, tear down method will be executed. But I want only for this particular scenario, I want to do some other precondition also, which is not applicable for scenario number 2 and 3. How to do that? For that thing, I have defined this add the red first over here. So I'll create another add the red before like this, and inside the bracket I'll write in double quotes add the red first. It means this add the red before is not a global, this is a local for only for first scenario. Okay, similarly this is also local only for first scenario, but it will be executed after the first scenario and it will be executed okay before the first scenario. Okay, but this also will be executed because this is a global, it is applicable for all the scenario. Fine. So first this preference will be given to this, then add the red before. So this is just like this in test ng, this is add the red before class, this is add the red before method like this. Similarly, this is add the red after class and this is add the red after method like this. You can define the tagging like this. Similarly, I have defined for second add the red before for second scenario, add the red after for second scenario. Similarly, add the red before for third scenario and add the red after for third scenario. And then I have defined all my three steps given when then like this. So all the preconditions I have defined over here like this. Right. Now, if you run this program, so what is my feature file? Tagged hooks. So let me give the feature file over here. Tagged hooks dot feature. And let me comment this feature file so that. Okay. And let me save this. Let's run this program. Well, let's see. See how many scenarios were there? Three scenarios. Scenario one, scenario two, and scenario 3. And if you see the output, see the output wise, if you see, first scenario will be executed with launch Firefox, enter URL, launch Firefox, enter URL, then before only first scenario, and three steps will be executed, then close the browser. Okay, that's a global. Okay, that's a global after, and that's only for first scenario. Okay, because of this add the red after for first scenario will be executed. Same thing for second scenario, same thing for third scenario like this. Okay, that is called tagged hooks. Okay, so tagged hooks also we can define. What do you mean by tagged hooks? Tagged hooks means if you want to execute any precondition for the specific scenario, okay, you can tag like this, add the red second, add the red third, add the red four, add the red five. And if you want to define any special condition for that particular scenario, only for, let's say, for this particular scenario, let's say only for create contact or only for create a deal, you want to do something else. You want to delete first deals and then you want to create it. Delete a deal is a precondition for creating a deal, right? So in that case, you can define such kind of tags like that. But deleting a deal is not applicable for other scenarios. So obviously, I won't write inside my global condition, which is only and only applicable for that particular method. That feature is missing in TestNG. In TestNG, if you write add the red before method, which is applicable for all the test methods, but you can define over here for this particular test method or test scenario, if you want to do something specific to precondition only for this particular second scenario, you can do that also. Or you can define the precondition and preconditions also with the help of add the red before like this. Okay, that is called tagging. You can define the ordering also, guys. Ordering also you can define. Let's see, I have a couple of preconditions I have written like this. Let's see, command C. I'll write like this. Okay. So for in tagging also, if you want to define like add that before, you have an annotation, I mean keyword order is equal to zero. First preference will be given to this order is equal to zero, and then order is equal to one. Same thing for this, order is equal to zero, order is equal to one. Okay, let's change the method name. Let's say step one and tear down one. Right, setup one, sorry. Okay, like this. So ordering also the first preference. So now there are four global methods are available. Four global hooks are available. Two for at the rate before, two for at the rate after. So first preference will be given to this at the rate before each and every scenario, and then this will be executed. Okay, 0 and 1. Same thing for at the rate after 0 and 1, like this. So ordering also you can define, okay, for hooks. So if you run this program, let's see. Everything is fine. If you see the output, now see. Launch Firefox, enter the URL for CRM. Again, launch Firefox, enter URL for CRM, like this. You see, launch Firefox, enter URL for CRM, and then launch Firefox, enter URL for CRM. For setup one. So ordering also you can define. But guys, too much of hooks and tagging is sometimes not recommended. For maintenance point of view, it will be very confusing. So make sure that okay, you are writing your code in a very precise way, in a very precise mode, in a very short way, in a very proper maintenance. Tomorrow if I'm joining your company, if it should be readable format. Some people they use in Cucumber so much amount of tagging and hooks. So many preconditions, post conditions, it will be a lot of confusion. Okay, so avoid so much hooks, so many hooks and tags in your framework. Make it very simple, make it very robust, make it very readable format. Otherwise, for the maintenance point of view, if you want to change any code and any precondition you want to change or any such kind of thing, it will be very, very difficult to maintain that. Sometimes what happens is that you're changing somewhere and it's impacting in some other area. Okay, so be careful while using hooks and tags. Okay, but it's very, very simple. You can practice easily and let me know if you have any issues. That's all for today. And with this particular concept, most of the things are done. I think almost everything we have covered in Cucumber. So this seven videos I have completed, different topics I have completed. I think almost everything we have completed in Cucumber. Only one thing is pending, that is page object model in Cucumber, that we will cover it later. Okay, so please practice. If you cover all these seven videos, you can do anything in Cucumber and you can survive easily, and you can design any kind of BDD Cucumber framework for different projects and applications. Okay, and you can definitely, you can 100% you can cover at a time of interview also. So that's all for today. I have already checked in this particular code into my Git repository. You can check it over here. This is my Git repository URL, right, in GitHub. And this is the project name, Cucumber Selenium Framework. And the code is available over here, right? So let me know if you have any issues. Please refer all these Cucumber videos, guys. Don't jump directly into 6th part or 7th part. Start from the first part 1, part 2, part 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And then jump into page object model in Cucumber. Okay? Don't directly jump into hooks and all those things. First, try to learn what is a step definition, what is feature file, right? What is a runner class? What are the different Cucumber options are available and all those things you have to understand first. Okay, so that's all for today. And let me know if you have any issues. And please, guys, subscribe to the channel. There are a lot of videos are coming so that you will be notified automatically. And let me know if you have any issues and questions. You can write down your questions in the comment section. Okay, thank you so much, guys. Thanks a lot for watching this video.